Hey folks, Alan Saunders, Doug Biega here from Pittsburgh Sports Live at Peterson Event Center. Panthers getting set to take on NC State, a team that's been down, but weirdly inconsistently down. They had a game where they only scored 27 points, a game where they scored 90 and lost in regulation. What's going on with the Wolfpack, Doug?
That's a really good question. I think we'll find a lot of that out today. Could be just a bad day that they had against Virginia Tech in the game in which you spoke of. They are a numbers team. They're a volume team. They throw a lot of players, a lot of shots at you. And when it's going well, it goes well. When it doesn't, it doesn't.
What have you seen from Pitt in this last couple games, especially we saw in that Wake Forest game, which just looked like a young team that wasn't able to put away what should have been a victory?
I totally agree with that, and I think what you're seeing is a lot of youth and inexperience. This is a long season. Basketball is a grind, and right now you're into mid-February. Everything's hard. Everything's heavy. Everything's harder at this point in the year, and I think on the road it's very difficult to win in those circumstances, especially in a conference like this.
I think in general Pitt's been a lot better at home. One of the things I wrote about was they're getting more foul calls at home. You know, when they have guards like McGowan's and Johnson that are going to drive against bigger guys, it's imperative that when they get fouled, they get to the foul line and they make their free throws.
Well, you need that. And like you said, when part of your mindset, part of your game planning is to drive with good guards to get those fouls and get to the foul line, that becomes a part of your identity. That becomes a part of your offensive game plan. So when you don't get those calls, that very much so adversely affects the outcome.
What's one thing you're looking forward to today?
I'm looking at the benches. NC State's bench is averaging 32 points a game. That's a high number. Pitt outshot NC State down in January 10th or January 12th down in Raleigh, but NC State's bench scored 54 points. If Pitt can control that NC State bench, I think they could win rather easily. If they don't, it could go south fast.
Pitt might be playing with a little bit less depth. Malik Ellison going to miss this one.
Right.
Adis Toney, still not sure if he's 100%, but he doesn't have the brace on his right hand. That's a good sign.
That's a good sign, but not having a full complement of players is a bad thing against a team that comes in waves at you. It's going to be a very interesting matchup.
All right, tip off next on the beat. Alan Saunders, Doug Biega, Pittsburgh Sports Live.
Enjoy the game.